for 2 years, I've kind of come to understand the different stages of dementia and how it not only affects the residents or patients that I've cared for, but also their families. Watching a loved one go through these changes in their life is extremely hard. I've dealt with many families who just don't understand how their loved one is so much different than they used to be. I've worked as a CNA for 2 years and recently got my Med-Aid, so I'm able to kind of go into the different medications that the different residents are on and see the effects that the medications have on them. So it's kind of interesting on that part of it. I know many of you don't work with dementia every day like I do, but it is a hard concept, and unfortunately there's no cure for it. So it's really hard, but learning about the basics is vital in being able to cope with it easier and understand it. So today I'll provide you information on dementia and its misconceptions, causes, and who is most susceptible, and what it is like to care for patients or residents with dementia. Dementia, according to the Encyclopedia Britannica, states a definition of dementia is a chronic, usually progressive deterioration of intellectual capacity associated with the widespread loss of nerve cells and the shrinkage of brain tissue. So dementia can happen at any age. It's stated also in the encyclopedia that in 2010, there was an estimated 35.6 million people that are affected by dementia, and that's said to double. It's expected to double by 2030. So that I thought that was kind of an interesting fact. So the most common misconception about dementia is that Alzheimer's and dementia are the same thing. Alzheimer's disease is the most common irreversible dementia. So it's a type of dementia, but they're not the same thing. Dementia has several different diseases or effects. According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, the simple definition for Alzheimer's is a disease of the brain that causes people to slowly lose their memory as they grow old. So their definitions are close, so that's why people are led to believe that they are the same thing, but Alzheimer's is actually a disease and dementia is just the more general loss of the brain tissue and capacity. So now, the causes and susceptibility. According to the Mayo Clinic, dementia caused by a reaction to medications and vitamin deficiencies, those can be treated. If you have adverse reactions to medications, you can have hallucinations, get really sick and lose some brain damage, but a lot of that can be treated. But other things such as Alzheimer's disease are ones that can't be cured. An article, it was kind of funny yesterday, I was at the doctor's office and I was sitting there, and we all know doctors take forever. So I was just looking around the room and I found this article titled Study Links Midlife Fitness to Lower Risk of Alzheimer's Disease. Dr. Jarrett Berry did a study and it indicated that people who maintain high midlife fitness are 36% lower risk of developing dementia, such as Alzheimer's. I thought that was kind of interesting. The biggest risk factors are age, family history, Down syndrome, and mild cognitive impairment. I have worked with several different residents and patients of many ages. I've had young residents who have had brain surgeries or been in car wrecks, or older residents who just have in their family. So there are several different reasons why you can have dementia or even Alzheimer's disease. So working with dementia patients is always interesting. I did an interview with one of my coworkers, and it's just, I don't know. Everyone says things in different ways, but the things I asked her was her favorite part of working with dementia residents, and she said being a part of their lives and building memories. As opposed to working in the hospital, I would have patients, different patients every day. So working at the nursing home, I'm able to build relationships with my residents. And the good thing about it, sometimes they'll be mad at you, and the next day you'll go in and you'll be their favorite person. So another thing I asked her was effective ways to redirect the residents. Some of them wonder, some of them try to steal things, some of them get mad, some of them bite you or hit you or kick you or, you know, and so you just have to think of ways to redirect them and get them off of whatever they're doing to try to get them to stop. So she said the most effective ways were to be one-on-one with them and redirecting them to a different area using another staff member, which is a good one because the residents will sometimes get upset with you. So if you're switching people, it helps to kind of change it up for them, or offering them a snack. They all love food, so snacks are always good. Something that Chris also added was that all residents are different and need a care plan on their wants, needs, and likes. All the residents have different issues, different causes, and all of them like to do different things. We have one that sews, which sometimes can be scary. One of them that helps us like clean up the kitchen. One of them that walks around with her babies all day. And just, I mean, they all have different things. They like different things. They eat different things or they don't eat things. But it's easy to lose your cool sometimes with these residents. When they're not doing what you ask them to do, sometimes they just don't understand or sometimes they just don't feel like listening to you. So it's easy to lose your cool. And Chris said when you start to feel like you're getting frustrated or angry with a resident, it's vital to let another staff member take over and let you take a break. It's easy to get caught up in your own feelings when you're dealing with these residents because they're not listening to you, and it's frustrating when someone's not listening to you. So once you feel yourself kind of getting caught up in your own feelings, it's important to let someone else take over and find a different way to kind of deal with that resident. These are just some pictures that kind of explain or kind of help people. That's just one showing all the different things they're feeling at one time and the different gears going out of their head, just all their stuff is just being lost basically. And those are showing that Alzheimer's disease, and it says vascular dementia and other dementia. So it's not only Alzheimer's disease, but it is a lot of it. So dementia is a hard concept, unfortunately. There's no cure for it, but today I've gone over the causes and misconceptions of it, who is most susceptible, and who and what it's like to deal with residents with Alzheimer's. I hope that as you get older or as your family gets older, that you'll remember this